Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to see how to automate Chrome extension. I'm going to do that using Selenium and as well as protractor. So let's see how to do that using Selenium. I'm going to automate this Chrome extension, which is Google Dictionary by Google. That's an awkward name, but that's okay. We are going to automate this thing, right? So I'm going to add to Chrome and it will ask the permission. It says that it can read and change all your data. That's okay. And then it will say like it has been added. Okay. The usage of this extension is you can click here and here you can search for anything. So let's find the meaning of define itself. So define, and here I'm going to click on the define. Now this is going to give us some result based on some Google Dictionary. Okay. Now we can change this to Hindi as well. So if I go to this option page, here I can change the language to Hindi, and once I click on this, then if I go and search for define again, so define, and if I click on define again, so now we are getting the meaning in Hindi, right? So this is what the scenario today. So we are going to automate this. Now let us understand the basic concept of extensions first. So here if I go to this Chrome:// extensions, here we have so many extensions. So I'm using so many extensions here, and here we have this extension part. And if you go down here, you can see that Chrome apps, right? So these are apps, okay, and these are extension. Now the major difference we will see in our Chrome extension development series. As of now, to automate, understand that there are majorly two types. One is extension type and another one is apps type. So in extension, we have to understand few keywords as well. So let me go to some blank page, maybe LetCode.in. Okay, so once I click on this, we are getting some HTML page, right? This HTML page is coming from this extension. Now this is known as pop-up page technically in terms of extension development. And once I do the right click and I click on options, this is known as options page. Okay, now if you see here we are getting this ID, right? So this URL is saying that option.html. most of the time this is how they have specified, but in your case it might be differs based on the developers, but mostly it is like either pop-up page or the options page. So we have to load this extension in our browser first, right? Because if I give this URL directly, I will not get anything, because obviously when we launched our Chrome browser using automation or using Selenium, it is not going to add any extension by default, right? So we have to add the extension. So for that, what we can do is we can go to this Windows R and app data. And within the app data, we have to navigate to local, then go to Google. So Google, and then go to Chrome, and within user data, here you will find a folder called extension. But I'm using 2-3 profiles. I'm going to go inside the default, and here I can see for extension. Now these are the extension I have in my browser, and this 25, which is today date, right? So this is the Chrome extension. I mean Google Dictionary, I think. Okay, so we are going to use this. So here I can see background, not this one, I think. Let me open this option.page. yeah, so we are going to use this one, right? So we have to load this within our script. So how do you do that? Okay, so Chrome extension are these files are actually converted into a zip file, which is actually not a zip, it is known as CRX file. Okay, so we are going to do that now. So where is the pop-up page? Let's find that. So maybe browser action. Yeah, so here instead of pop-up page, they have named it as browser_action, right? Okay, that's fine. We will anyway take this. So here I'm going to copy the entire file path. And here within my Chrome extension, so Chrome:// extensions, here I'm going to pack the extension. Now by default, you might not see this option. You have to toggle this. Okay, so turn on developer mode and then click on pack extension, and here you have to specify your file path, basically the path we copied, right? And then this is optional, so leave as it is, and here you can pack extension. Now this will say that it has been created within the same folder. So if I go back to that folder, so here I can find a CRX file basically. So if I go back and here, yes, so we are getting this CRX file, right? So let me copy this, and if I go to my VS Code, here I can paste that, so it will be very easy to access. Sometimes when you try to load from this C folder, you might get permission denied error. So just copy the CRX file and paste in your working directory. Now within this, I'm going to create a main method, and here I'm going to call my Chrome driver. So Chrome driver, driver equal to new Chrome driver, basic stuff, right? Now here I'm going to say driver.get, and here we will load that URL. But before that, let us try to add the extension to our browser, right? So here I'm going to use the Chrome options. So here we have a method called add extension, right? So we are going to use this. So add extension, and this is asking for file path, right? So if I mouse over on this, you can see that it needs a file, right? So here we are going to get the file. So new file, and import it from java.io. And here we have to specify the file path, which is 4.1.5. Let's rename this as app, so it will be easier to access. So here I'm going to say app.crx. So by default, it is going to take from our project folder, right? That's fine. Now we have to pass this option to our Chrome driver constructor. Now let's try to launch this. Maybe we'll see that the extension has loaded successfully or not. So I'm going to run this, and this is going to bring my browser. And yes, we got it, right? So here you can see this Google extension. We got this, right? Google Dictionary. Fine. So we are able to achieve this successfully. Now there are two things you might get as an exception. One is permission error, because you are trying to access it directly from your C folder. So just copy the extension file and put it in your workspace. Second thing, you might get an exception saying that CRX3 or CRX2 is not compatible, something like that. So what you have to do is you have to pack it again. So ask your developer, they will do for you. Or else, as I did here, pack extension, you can do that. That will convert your file into CRX3 format. Now let's understand how we can open this pop-up page, right? So here we can see that it has some ID. Now each and every Chrome extension has a unique ID. So based on this ID, we can automate things. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to open new tab. And here I'm going to say Chrome-extension, and then :// and paste the ID. And then we know that this browser_action.html is our actual file, right? So I'm going to just copy and paste it here. Now if I hit enter, I'm able to see this, right? So let's try to do something. Let's say that hey and define. So here we are obviously getting our answer, I mean our meanings, right? So this we have to pass within our driver.get. So what I'm going to do is, here within the driver.get, here I'm going to pass this stuff. That's okay. Now let's first run this, and then we'll move on. So let's run this first. Yeah, so we got this browser, right? So we are able to get this, and here we can type something, and we can click on the define everything. So these are basic how you used to write your Selenium script or protractor script or WebDriver IO script. So this is going to be very similar. So let me quickly inspect and check what we have here. I believe there should be ID, because that is how everything was designed. Yeah, so we have ID, so I can take this. So here I'm going to say driver.find element by ID, not this one. So find element by ID, And here I'm have to pass the value, and then I'm going to type something. So dot send keys, and within this I have to pass my search data. So let's do with the define itself. And then what I have to do, I have to click on the define button, right? So let me inspect this. So here we have ID, which is define button. So let's driver dot find element by ID very quickly. And here I'm going to dot click, right? So obviously I have to write some web driver wait logic to wait for the text to appear, but I'm just going to use the thread.sleep as of now. Now, I know this is not a good practice, but I'm not here to teach you the exception, I mean explicit wait and all. So I'm just going to use the thread.sleep as of now. So here maybe 5 seconds. Yes. Now after that, here we are getting this thing. So let's print this whatever we are getting in the header. So here we have this class called head word, right? So let me copy this, and here driver dot maybe I can use the class name. So find element by class name, and here I'm going to pass this, and here we'll use the get text and we will print this. Okay, so let me store that into a local variable, and here I'm going to just text is fine, and here I'm going to log this. Okay, so sysout and text. Okay, now we are getting some error here because of course we have to handle the what we call that exception, right? So thread.sleep, and why I'm not getting any suggestion. Oh, sorry for that. I have to pass within the integers, not this thing. Okay, my bad. So now I'm getting compile time error, so I have to add the throws declaration or try catch, anything is fine. That's okay, right? Now let's first try to run this and we will print something so that we can make sure it's working till now. Okay, so of course it's defined, going to search for the defined word, and it's getting some meanings, and I hope that we are getting as define dot something like that, which we got here, right? So define, yeah, so we got this word. So here you can see we are getting the exact output as we wanted, right? Now what we are going to do is we are going to change this to option page, right? So we will go to this option page, and from there we can change the language, right? So let me copy this URL and let me click here. So here I'm going to again, so driver dot get, and here I'm going to pass this URL, and after that I'm going to select this one, right? So let me inspect this, and it has a language selector as in select, so I can use that. So driver dot find element by ID, and by ID, and here within this I have to pass this. Now let us store this in a web element. So assign to a new local variable, and this is going to be your language selector. That's fine. And here I'm going to pass that within the select constructor. So new select, not this select, so new select. And here I'm going to pass my web element, which is this LAN select. And here I'm going to say dot select by visible text maybe. So select by visible text. And here I'm going to pass this as Hindi, right? So let me quickly copy this. So where this guy? Yeah. So copy and paste it here. That's fine. Now, also we have to click on the save button, right? So quickly find that. So within this we have this save button which has ID, so I'm going to take that. And here driver dot find element by maybe by dot ID in this time, so by dot ID, and here we can pass the value, then I can click on this, right? So click on this, right? Now it's going to save this, so that's going to work fine, I think. So after that what we can do is again we can load this website now. So we can repeat the same stuff here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just convert this to a method. So maybe get data. Okay, And here we can see for a private static get data. Okay, so here we are going to print this value, right? So it's going to print for two times. Yeah, so let's call this method again. So get data here also, after once we save the data, I mean save the language selection, once we change the language selection, then again I'm going to call the same method here. Okay, so let me close my all my terminals and let me run this, then I will explain you again. Okay, so let it be run. So first time it's going to search for the define, and it is going to give us an English meaning. Then it is going to search for, it was very quick guys, so you can see the differences, right? So we got this now Hindi, Hindi meaning. So it was very quick, I think. So here in the console you can see, right? So we are getting this thing. Okay, so let me explain you the code again. So it is very easy. It is like basically like how we automate our regular pages, the same thing is going to be happen here also. Only difference is how we are going to load the Chrome extension. Okay, so first thing, remember that you have to pack your extension and make that as an CRX file. Now now there are plenty of websites available which can do that, but I will not recommend you to do that because that might bring some a code error, or maybe it can break your package. So instead of that, you can use the inbuilt function or inbuilt option in the Chrome browser itself. So you can do that. And then here we are writing, converted this code into a method so that I no need to write the code again and again. So here the only thing you have to remember is how we are going to load the Chrome extension, right? So first time we have loaded this browser dot, browser underscore action dot HTML, which is our pop-up page. And let me write a comment here. So here it is going to be our pop-up page, and here this is going to be our option page. So option page is basically the settings of that particular extension. Okay, so I hope this is very clear to you. There are some limitations as well, so you cannot do all the stuff. For example, if you check extensions like Grammarly, they are very complicated to automate because they are using the shadow DOM concept, and we know that Selenium is very not much apt for the shadow DOM. So that kind of automating extension are going to be really challenge for that. Maybe if time permits, we will do that. And this type of simple applications are going to be very easy if you have this pop-up page and the option page. And some of the applications have right-click, context-click to do that. I don't think that possible. I will try to figure it out. If I find any solution, I will update in our channel. And that's pretty much enough. We are going to do the same stuff using protractor in the next video. So if you like the video, hit the thumbs up, and if you are new here, please do subscribe. That's it from my side. I hope you have learned something new and you have enjoyed the video. See you in the next one. Tada, bye bye.